using the Laplace transform to solve the initial value problem. So for this one on the left side, let me do step by step from left to right. So on the left side, apply the derivative theorem. I have s squared times capital Y of s minus s squared of 0 minus y prime of 0 minus 2s capital Y of s plus 2y of 0 equals, for this one, L of this is 1 over s plus, so this is called the direct delta function. And if you don't remember, the Laplace transform of direct delta function is equal to e to the negative s t naught. So whatever t naught is, you just plug in. So that means I have e to the negative 2s, okay? Okay, now, plug in the conditions, y of 0 equals 0, so this becomes 0, this becomes 0. So looking at capital Y of s is, factor out capital Y of s, I have s squared minus 2s, okay, equals 1 over s plus e to the negative 2s. And y prime of 0 equals 1, negative 1, move to the right, become positive 1. Now divide both sides by s squared minus 2s. So I have 1 over s times s squared minus 2s plus e to the negative 2s over s squared minus 2s plus 1 over s squared minus 2s, okay? Factor out the s, I have 1 over s squared times s minus 2 plus 1 over s times s minus 2 e to the negative 2s plus 1 over s times s minus 2. Okay, so these are, we are good for these because we can find these transform easily with my method. Okay, and for this one, it's not easy, right? So we have to use partial fraction decomposition. So let's see, let me do it over here. So 1 over s where s minus 2 equals a over s plus b over s squared plus c over s minus 2. The LCD is this, so multiply both sides by that LCD gives me 1 equals a s s minus 2 plus b s minus 2 plus c s squared. Let s above 0, I have 1 equals, it eliminates this and this, so I have negative 2b. Then b equals negative 1 half. Okay. Yeah, b equals negative 1 half. Let s approach 2. I have 1 equals, it eliminates this and this, so 4c. So c equals 1 fourth. Now let's take a look at the leading coefficient of s squared. So we have a plus c equals 0 because we have nothing on the right, on the left. We know c, which is 1 fourth, so a has to be negative 1 fourth. Right, now plug them back in. So this one becomes, a, which is negative 1 fourth over s plus b, negative 1 half. Over s where plus c 1 fourth over s minus 2. For this one, so you, if you don't know the shortcut, the method I'm about to use, you have to use partial fraction again, right? So I'm gonna use the shortcut, and you know the, and that shortcut says we need to have something over s plus something over s minus 2, right? Of course. This can be obtained from the summation of these two fractions. And don't forget to multiply by this. So as you can see, these are off by 2. So I'm going to have 1 half on top. And the next step is to determine which one has the negative sign. So as I experienced, the bigger one, the bigger denominator will carry the negative sign. So this one will carry the negative sign. If you're not sure, you can double check by crossing multiplying. Negative 1 half, 1s, times s, plus 1 half s. 0, negative 1 half times negative 2, which is 1, right? So that is correct. And, the plus right here. And for this one, Well, this exactly, it looks exactly the same as this one, so you just bring it over. Negative 1 half over s plus 1 half over s minus 2, right? Okay. We're almost done. So, simplify. Yeah, we can simplify it. This one, this one. So negative 1 fourth minus 1 half gives me multiply by 2 negative 3 fourth over s. Okay, and s minus 2, this one. So 1 fourth, 1 half, positive 3 fourths s minus 2 minus plus negative 1 half s squared. Plus, we write this. Okay, now let's take the L inverse on both sides. So I have negative 3 fourths plus 3 fourths e to the 2t minus 1 half t plus. So let's do this first. That is u of t minus 2, okay? For this one, you will have negative 1 half plus 1 half e to the 2t, right? But because you, again, you have the unit step function, so the t has to match up, which means that you are going to have t minus 2 eventually, right? The t match up here. The t matches up. Alright, so this is your final solution. That's it.
If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.